Hey, welcome back again to another video. So in this video we're going to look at the one of the effects in Kdenlive, and that is the spot remover. So when do we use a spot remover? When you have a text or any logo that is in your screen and you just want to blur it out, you can use the spot remover to do that. Let's see how we can do that. First of all, let's bring this video clip already here on the timeline. So the next thing is to create a title clip. So let's come to the project bin here and then right click and then add the title clip. In the title clip, let's type in our text. You can see that I have this enabled the background to be shown on the text editor here. Now if you don't have this, come down here, you can see the show background, and make sure to click on the check to check this check mark box here to show the background. Once we have that, now we can type in our text. So this flower is called bignonias, so let's type in the name. Okay, so we have this. Let's place this in a location that we want to place this text, and that's all we need to do. And let's click on the create title to create our title. So here's our title. Let's just bring this down to the timeline as well, and make this equal to the video clip for the purpose of this video. And since we want to apply the effect to this text here, first let's create a sequence. So to create a sequence, hold down the shift button and then do a rubber select to select how many clips that you have on your timeline. And then you can do a right click, and you can see here a create sequence from the selection. If you don't have this, make sure to upgrade your Kdenlive to 23.04.1 so that you can have the create sequence from selection. Okay, so let's create that, and you can see here it says the video tracks 2, which is the text title clip and the video clip itself, and there was no audio clip, so you can see audio tracks is 0. So once you have that, you can also rename your track here, so you can name the sequence here. So let's click OK, and you can see it's placed this again on the timeline. And here you can see the sequences, that is where our sequence created will be appearing here. So let's just bring this down and let's just delete the original one there. And you can see now we just want to blur this text out. So to do that, let's go to the effects panel here, and then make sure to select the show video effects only, or you can always be in here to use these effects. Now up alpha mask and king, and once you come down to the second last effect here, you can see the spot remover. Simply apply that, and you can see this is the spot remover on the screen here. So you can place anywhere and it's kind of blurred the spot out. So here, once you put here, you can see it's getting up space and it's not fitting in the text, so we have to adjust the height and the width. Coming to the property or the parameter of the spot remover, you can see we have the width and the height here. So in the width, let's type in 320 to be the length of the text here. So whatever image that you have, you can always type that. So let's go up to 340. That will be enough to cover up the text. And now for the height, let's go down to 60. So you can see this is the length of width of 340 by height of 360. So when we place in here, you can see there already it does the magic. It's hiding the text, to blur it out, so you can see there's no text here, but you can see the a little bit of transparent, but it's kind of opaque in it, so you can see that there. Okay, so there you go. If you have any logo or text that you want to hide it, make sure to jump over to Kdenlive and use the spot remover, and you can be able to hide that out. Thank you again for watching.